Good afternoon, you're on Newsroom 365, I'm Anand Narasimhan. Ladies and gentlemen, a few days ago we had told you here on Times Now that the opposition is going to gang up to try and block the passage of the Triple Talaq Bill because they just cannot believe that the government will actually follow through on its poll commitment. An aspect which got the BJP surprisingly not just an overwhelming mandate but also a lot of support within the constituency of Muslim women. The issue of ban on talaq-e-biddat and criminalization of all those who resort to giving instant teen talaq or triple talaq in just one sitting. Just a short while ago in Parliament, the Union Law Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad tabled the bill and there was a fierce counter that came through not from anyone but Asaduddin Owaisi. Here's what transpired.
I beg to move for leave to introduce a bill to protect the rights of married Muslim women and to prohibit divorce by pronouncing triple talaq by their husbands and to provide for matters connected therewith or incidental thereto.
Objection to the introduction of this bill is twofold. One, the parliament lacks legislative competence because this bill violates the fundamental rights. Secondly, madam, this bill lacks basic legal coherence and is inconsistent existing legal framework. Madam, I have given this to you, madam. Yes. You have it in front of. Let me at least put it to the front of the house. Madam, you reject it. Let me put it in front of the house. Why I am saying it is violating Article 415. Yes. Madam, it is a settled law that for discrimination to happen, lack of intelligent differentia, lack of rational nexus. Madam, talaq-e-biddat has already been called void, set aside. Now with this legislation, you are creating another law where is already provisions under Law on Domestic Violence Act exist. IPC sections are already there. And you cannot criminalize a similar action when law is there. Why it lacks rational nexus? Because you have 498A IPC. You have section 2022 of Domestic Violence Act. You have Art Section 125, Madam, complete, and Women's Protection of Divorce 1986. Arbitrary nature of punishment, Madam, arbitrary nature of punishment of 3 years. Supreme Court in E.P. Royappa clearly said that right to equality includes right against arbitrariness. Now I will be put in prison, detention for what? This is arbitrariness. Rohinton Nariman judgment is there, which the Honourable Minister knows very well. Lastly, Madam. There is an absence of consistency with existing legal framework. Why I say that, madam? Because this bill says that if a person is sent to prison, conjugal rights will remain. He will pay substance allowance. A person who is in jail will pay an allowance, madam. What law are you creating? And lastly, in this house itself, the Honourable Minister accepted in the start question of 8-1 that consultation did not happen. Madam, this bill, if it is passed, will be an injustice to Muslim women, will lead to abandonment of Muslim women. What the bill is required is to make a law wherein 20 lakh women who are abandoned by married people who do not belong to Muslim community, which also includes our Bhabhi in Gujarat, should be given justice, madam. It is not being done by this bill.
We'll play out the Union Law Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad's response to Asaduddin Owaisi's objections in just a bit. But what stands out is that the patriarchy has stood up on the floor of the house to try and block gender justice and to try and block something that itself is bid'at as far as the Islamic Sharia or the personal law. Let's listen into what Ravi Shankar Prasad said.
Aaj hum itihas bana rahe hain. Ye jo aapattiyan aayi hain, main ek baat kehna chahunga. ये पूरा कानून न किसी पूजा का है, न प्रार्थना का है, न इबादत का है, न मजहब का है। ये कानून है नारी न्याय, नारी गरिमा और नारी सम्मान का। दूसरी बात मैं कहना चाहूंगा, सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने तलाक-ए-बिद्दत को गैर कानूनी कहा। अगर उसके बाद भी तीन तलाक चलता है, लोग महिलाएं सड़कों पे फेंक दी जाती हैं, उनके गुजारे का कोई इंजाम नहीं होता है, तो क्या ये सदन खामोश रहेगी? सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने कहा ये पाप है, पाप के बावजूद अगर ये पाप किया जाएगा तो क्या ये सदन खामोश रहेगी? तीसरी बात, ये लोग राइट टू इक्वालिटी की बात कर रहे हैं, ये फंडामेंटल राइट की बात कर रहे हैं। माननीय अध्यक्ष महोदया, आज इस सदन को ये तय करना है कि तीन तलाक की पीड़ित महिलाओं का, बेटियों का, बहनों का फंडामेंटल राइट है या नहीं, ये तय करना पड़ेगा। इसलिए ये कानून जब सुप्रीम कोर्ट के द्वारा इस पूरे मामले को गैर कानूनी कहा गया, उसके बाद भी तीन तलाक चल रहा है और कोई कार्रवाई नहीं की गई, तब ये सरकार ने यह कानून लाया है। सिर्फ इसमें चार क्लॉज है, अब एक बात कही जा रही है बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर के खिलाफ है। मैं कहूंगा क्या इस मुल्क की हमारी बहनों का जो राइट है आर्टिकल 14-15 में अगेंस्ट डिस्क्रिमिनेशन, वो बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर है या नहीं, ये मैं जानना चाहता हूं। अब उधर से बात कही गई आप इसको अपराध क्यों बना रहे हैं, मैं एक बात आपके सामने इस सदन को रखना चाहता हूं और सदन के माध्यम से देश को रखना चाहता हूं। अगर तीन तलाक गैर कानूनी हो गया, फिर भी अगर पति अपने पत्नी को तीन बार तलाक करके बाहर करते हैं, मेरे पास आज सुबह की एक खबर है रामपुर में कि पत्नी लेट से उठी, उसको तीन तलाक दे दिया, तो ये बिल्कुल कानूनी है और भारत के संविधान के कंकरेंट लिस्ट के एंट्री 5 में इस सदन को पूरा अधिकार है इस कानून को लाए, इसलिए इस कानून को लाया है। मैं आपसे आग्रह करूंगा कि मुझे इस कानून को इंट्रोड्यूस करने की अनुमति दी जाए।
I have Sujay Kantawala and Hafiz Saeed Akhtar. Hafiz Saeed Akhtar is the executive member of the All India Muslim Personal Law Board. Sujay Kantawala, very senior lawyer with us. Good afternoon, gentlemen. Mr. Hafiz Saeed Akhtar, what is the problem? Because you know yourself that in the days old, talaq-e-biddat was also punishable. So, as per the Constitution of India, if it's now made punishable, where is the problem?
देखिए, सबसे पहली बात तो ये है कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने अपने रीसेंट वर्डिक्ट में यह बात कही है कि इंस्टिंक्ट ट्रिपल तलाक, पहली बात तो यह है कि सब ट्रिपल तलाक कह रहे हैं, ट्रिपल तलाक कह रहे हैं, ट्रिपल तलाक की बात नहीं, बात है इंस्टिंक्ट ट्रिपल तलाक।
मैंने अभी क्या बैठक में मैंने अभी तलाक की बिद्दत कहा ना,
सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने साफ
मैंने भी आपको तलाक की बिद्दत ही कहा,
आपने इंस्टिंक्ट ट्रिपल तलाक कहा है, लेकिन जो हवा
जी हां
लेकिन जो हवा उड़ाई जा रही है वो ट्रिपल तलाक पे उड़ाई जा रही है, तलाक की बिद्दत कोई नहीं कह रहा, आप कह रहे हैं, लेकिन सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने कहा है कि इंस्टिंक्ट ट्रिपल तलाक अगर कोई देता है तो तलाक एप्लीकेबल ही नहीं होता, तलाक उसका इंप्लीमेंटेशन ही नहीं होगा। तो हमारा पूछना यह है कि जो तलाक सुप्रीम कोर्ट के पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से, उनके वर्डिक्ट के एतबार से तलाक ही नहीं है, तो उस पर पनिशमेंट किस बात का,
क्योंकि जो चीज बैंड है जब उसको करते हैं तो वो गलत होता है ना, तो उसके लिए पनिशमेंट होता है, दैट इज द हाउ द लॉ इज, जो एक चीज बिद्दत है, जो गलत है, जो बैंड है, अगर उसे कोई करता है तो वो क्रिमिनल एक्ट होगा,
नहीं हो रही है
तो क्रिमिनल एक्ट होगा, इंप्लीमेंट नहीं हो रही है। आप तो कह रहे हैं
क्रिमिनल,
आप तो अभी कह रहे हैं, पर हस्बैंड ने अगर तीन तलाक दे दिया, वाइफ को बाहर कर दिया, तो वाइफ कहां जाएगी, वो औरत कहां जाएगी, आप बताइए।
नहीं
सुजय कांटेवाला,
नहीं तो आप सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने कह दिया है, ठीक है, सुप्रीम कोर्ट कह रहा है कि वो तलाक ही नहीं हुई तो काहे के लिए उसको बाहर फेंकेंगे,
तो
फेंक नहीं सकते, अगर वो उसको फेंकता है
उसके लिए आप रहेंगे, आप जानते हैं आफ्टर द बैन हैज बीन अनाउंस्ड मिस्टर हाफिज सईद अख्तर, कम से कम चार ऐसे मौके हुए जहां ये बात हुई है और जहां औरत के साथ और वुमन के साथ बिल्कुल एक तरह से नाइंसाफी हुई है, बदसलूकी भी हुई है। Now, Sujay Kantawala, please tell me, is there anything that stops criminalization of talaq-e-biddat after the court?
और मुझे कहना है,
एक मिनट आप सही सकते हैं, I'm bringing in Sujay Kantawala, फिर आपको आपके पास फिर आऊंगा सर। Yes, Sujay Kantawala.
Anand, under the Constitution, the Supreme Court is vested with extraordinary powers, and every judgment of the Supreme Court is unconditionally binding throughout the territory of India. Once the Supreme Court has declared the law and a particular proposition in law, the government has to fall in line and has to pass an appropriate legislation. So the government, that is the law minister, is only doing and obeying the order of the Supreme Court. But unfortunately, in direct defiance of the Supreme Court judgment, there are people who are indulging in this mischief of violating consciously the Supreme Court judgment after being widely publicized. Now, this is a criminal contempt of the Supreme Court, and every person who violates the Supreme Court judgment is in criminal contempt, in any case is liable to be arrested. So therefore, it is not in your choice. You have to follow it.
Yes.
And therefore the government has brought it because crores of women have suffered till today, and there crores of Muslim women are also citizens of this country. They have every right to live with dignity and honor, and therefore their fundamental rights are in question. So I don't see what is the great difficulty.
No, and not
over
just that,
Sujay
Katwala, you have to also make, you have to also, case, you have to also turn around and tell those people who are saying that an act of divorce, which is an end of a contract, is being criminalized. That's not the case. An act of illegal divorce is being criminalized. An act of divorce, which is even bidat as far as the Sharia, yes, has been criminalized, because even Hafiz Saeed Akhtar and others who understand Muslim personal law will know that talaq-e-bidat in the days of the yore was also liable to punishment. So people might accept it, but it was also liable to punishment.
Yes.
Today, Muslim countries are saying this kind of instant, yes, triple talaq or talaq in one sitting is banned, is wrong. There are other countries in the world that have criminalized it.
Yes.
And you can go to jail, yes, for it.
Yes. Yes. In fact, Islam recognizes equality of man and woman. I think it's a very practical aspect of Islam that it actually inherently recognizes that man and woman are equal. So how this unequal treatment is given, that is what the law seeks to curtail. And if there are people who are mischievously and deliberately violating the Supreme Court judgment, Anand, they have to face the wrath of the law. It cannot be permitted. You cannot violate, you cannot defy consciously the judgment of the Supreme Court. And that is why this law has been brought into effect. It is being proposed today in the Lok Sabha. Mm. And I think that the Muslim women who are equal citizens, equally...
Right. Now, Sujay, I'm just interrupting you because along with the blockade, there has also been a serious criticism coming forth from the BJP. The BJP hitting out and saying GVL Narasimha Rao has just taken to Twitter and said Rahul Owaisi bhai bhai naya rajnitik nara hai. Unki partiyan triple talaq bill mein apradhik pravdhan ka virodh kar rahi hain. Muslim mahilaon ke samvedhanik adhikaron se inkar karte hain. Kya Rahul Gandhi ab pita Rajiv Gandhi ki Shah Banu mamle mein Muslim mahilaon ke vishwasghat ki nakal kar rahe hain? That is the word, that's what the BJP is asking. Rajiv Gandhi intervened and overturned the Supreme Court judgment as far as by passing an ordinance back in 1985 in the Shah Banu case, overt case of appeasement, and we know what the net fallout of all of that was. But, and it tore into the social fabric of the society. GVL Narasimha Rao has also reacted, let's listen in.
Parties like the Congress, OYC, who are opposing the triple talaq bill or its provisions, are actually wanting to indulge in exploitation of Muslim women. They want Muslim women to be denied their fundamental rights of equality guaranteed under the Constitution. They are ignoring the judgment of the Honorable Supreme Court, which held instant triple talaq to be unconstitutional and illegal. They are doing it only to placate Rahul Gandhi, OYC, they're all doing this to only, and Mamata Banerjee and the likes of them are doing this to placate the radical Muslim fundamentalist groups, and they want to deny equal rights to women. I think it's highly condemnable that mainstream political parties are wanting to really betray the Constitution.
That's what GVL Narasimha Rao said. Shazia Elmi is with us on the phone, and so is Ms. Subhashini Ali. Ms. Subhashini Ali, what is this entire ruckus created by the opposition all about? Why should they stand up against gender justice?
And then listen, why are you putting words into my mouth? I'm saying that we have always been opposed to this practice of triple talaq. There's no question that it is a completely unjust practice. And the marriage should not end by pronouncement of triple talaq in one sitting. That is what the Supreme Court has also said. That is what the women are demanding also.
Ji.
Now, what you do in the situation is should be geared towards helping the marriage to continue, the marriage to survive, giving place for negotiation, for talk, so that the marriage can be, you know, can continue. That's what the women want, and the women's rights and the children's rights should be protected. Now, the point is that when you criminalize something and something is happening which is not well thought out, then in fact you may be stalling the process of reconciliation itself because of this. There should be a punishment that should be discussed. I think the bill should be discussed. The best thing would be if it went to a standing committee and then women's organizations, Muslim women, other groups and legal experts could all give their suggestions.
Hmm. Now, Shazia Almi, you want to respond to Subhashini Ali, her point of view? Do you agree, disagree with what Ms. Ali says?
No, I think the triple talaq, because it is deemed unconstitutional, it has to be criminalized. There, the laws do not exist in vacuum. Whenever there is a case of dowry or domestic violence, are they not punishable? If a man indulges in something that is an act of crime or illegal in the eyes of the constitution, should it not be criminalized? So I think it should be criminalized. One can discuss the quantum of punishment and the way in which recompensation will be provided to the woman concerned, to the wife and the children. But the fact of the matter is, criminalization is important, is going to be an important deterrent to prevent something as pernicious as this. This is not just against the constitution, this is against the tenets of Quran. This is inhuman. So I do not understand why all kinds of smart legalese is being used to deviate and derail this important process. We will not allow our Shah Bano judgment to be repeated here. We will not allow for that to happen.
And not just that, Ms. Ilmi, that the other aspect people don't realize is that in the case of dowry, if there is a case and the woman goes to the law, goes to the police, files a complaint, then it becomes punishable by law because there is a case registered. There is always the opportunity of reconciliation. The Teen Talaq Bill also gives the women the legal recourse, the option of legal recourse, along with the option of having a reconciliation.
The fact of the matter is that because if a woman is just thrown out arbitrarily with the utterance of talaq, she has nowhere to go. At least now she can report a case. She can quote a section of the IPC or CRPC and say that this is, and she can have a lawyer backing her using the IPC and CRPC to prevent for something like that to happen. If it is not punishable, what is the point? How is there a deterrent? Where is the fear of the law? Do we want our women to live in a constant state of fear?
True. Ms. Shazia Almi, I thank you for speaking to us. Ms. Subhashini Ali, thank you for speaking to us. Mr. Afis Saeed and Sujay Kantawala, please stay on. We'll go across to our reporters also who've been speaking to various voices on ground, not just in Parliament, but also in Uttar Pradesh, from where this entire issue actually started and became a very strong poll bank for the BJP. Quite surprising, the opposition, and also making inroads into the Muslim vote bank, especially among the women. We take a very short break and we join you with more. The RJD, one of the key vote banks and the planks for them is the welfare of Muslims along with the OBCs and the other classes. And this is what won them the mandate in Bihar. But Lalu's team seems to be opposed to gender justice. And that patriarchy shone through even in Parliament today when they stood with Asaduddin Owaisi and the Biju Janata Dal to try and block the triple talaq bill in Parliament. This is what the RJD has to say. Jay Prakash speaking to us.
का सजा का प्रावधान जो हुआ है ये सही नहीं है क्रिमिनल ऑफेंस जो है सही नहीं है मुस्लिम प्रतिनिधियों से बात करना चाहिए प्रश्न लाभ और मशवरा और सहमति का बिंदु तलाशना चाहिए राजनीतिक उद्देश्य को सामने रखकर कोई काम नहीं करना चाहिए.
Who was he talking about? One Only Wonders. Amir Haq joins us live. We'll also go across to Arunil Sadadekar in Mumbai, who's with some of those people who have had to bear the brunt of Talaq-e-Biddat. But Amir, first up, coming to you in Lucknow, what's the word on ground? Do you believe, have you been able to speak to multiple constituents and are they welcoming this move by the government? Ravi Shankar Prasad is just speaking, going across to that, Amir.
तीन तलाक की पीड़ित महिलाओं को सुप्रीम कोर्ट के आदेश के बावजूद जो परेशानी और पीड़ा हो रही थी उसको एड्रेस करने का जो कानून है वो लोकसभा में हमने इंट्रोड्यूस कर दिया है. सदन में चर्चा होगी. बाकी मुझे जो कुछ भी कहना है मैं सदन के अंदर ही कहूंगा.
Well, we'll say whatever else outside in Parliament, not outside, but they said that the bill has been tabled. We're also plenty of reactions coming through. Dr. Swami has spoken, so has Kiran Kher. We're also getting voices from the opposition, from the Congress. Now the Home Minister, Rajnath Singh, speaking.
निर्भर करता है। मैं समझता हूँ सदन से पारित कर। अब देखिए हाउस में चूंकि इस पर चर्चा हो रही है इसलिए मैं इस संबंध में कुछ नहीं कहना चाहूंगा। चर्चा समाप्त हो जाने के बाद जो भी आप प्रश्न करेंगे उसका मैं उत्तर दूंगा।
Once again, they're all saying that the bill has been tabled, expressing solidarity and coming out and saying they will speak at length once the discussion in the House is over. I have Sharon joining us, Amir Haq with us. Mr. Hafiz Saeed stays on and so does Mr. Sujay Kantawala. But Amir, coming across to you first, what's been the reaction on ground? Is there a larger sentiment which says that they are happy that the government has followed through? They have lived up to their promise and what they told the people?
Well, Anand, the Muslim community is clearly divided here as far as the response to this bill is concerned. While the All India Muslim Personal Law Board, which already has done an emergency meeting out here in the Nadwatul Ulema in Lucknow, is of the opinion that this is clearly a draconian law, that this goes against the principle of justice to Muslim women and children, and they've raised objections and questions like who will actually pay for maintenance of such women who are given triple talaq and then their husbands are relegated to jail. How will they sustain when their husbands are actually sent to jail? But there are a number of Muslim women who've actually come forward, Muslim women activists as well as women who've actually gone through the trauma of actually being victims of instant triple talaq, including Atiya Sabri there in Saranpur, who was actually quite instrumental in taking this this triple talaq issue to the Supreme Court. They are clearly of the view that they support the government's endeavor of bringing in this new law.
Well,
and
I mean,
they clearly feel
people,
that if
those people who are trying to oppose it, what those people who are trying to oppose miss, and they are missing altogether, is the fact that this is an option for legal recourse and help that is given to the woman. Yes, triple talaq should also act, this triple talaq bill should also act as a deterrent to those people who feel they can get away with talaq-e-biddat. Sujay, that's the important aspect before I go across to Shireen. That's the important aspect, that the woman has a legal recourse. She has somebody that she can turn to, that is the constitution of this country and the legal process to get justice if she believes injustice has been meted out to her.
And therefore, Anand, I think this is even stronger than the Hindu Marriage Act. And I fail to understand what kind of people are opposing this. Because it actually is a very, very well-balanced piece of legislation in sync with what the Supreme Court sentiment was. It actually guarantees all the Muslim women a basic right to seek justice if they have been violated in any manner whatsoever. So therefore, I totally welcome this kind of legislation, and after a long time one sees a such a well-balanced piece of legislation.
Well, Mr. Hafiz Saeed, sir, let me just quickly get a word in from you. ये बात क्यों नहीं आप समझा रहे हैं लोगों को कि ये जो है ये एक जरिया है, एक ऑप्शन है फॉर द वुमेन, कि अगर उनके साथ इंस्टेंट तीन तलाक होता है या तलाक विद्दत उनको दी जाती है तो बियॉन्ड द रेकंसिलिएशन इन सोसाइटी एक लीगल रिकोर्स का ऑप्शन है उनके पास।
देखिए, आपने आदत के मुताबिक मुझे उस वक्त पूरी तरह से बोलने नहीं दिया
जी।
मैं यही कहने जा रहा था कि जिस आदमी को आप तीन साल के लिए तलाक देने पर, इंस्टेंट ट्रिपल तलाक देने पर जेल में डाल रहे हैं और दूसरी तरफ उसके जिम्मे कर रहे हैं कि वो उस अपनी औरत को मेंटेनेंस दे, तो आप मुझे बताइए कि जो आदमी तीन साल के लिए जेल में जाएगा वो बीवी बच्चों को कैसे पालेगा, कैसे मेंटेनेंस देगा। दूसरी बात, अभी इन्होंने भी एक क्या कहते हैं माननीय उन्होंने कहा सदस्य ने पार्लियामेंट के
जी, उस व्यक्ति के पास कोई एसेट्स नहीं है। उस व्यक्ति के पास सर, ये सरकार जब उसको तीन साल जेल भेजेगी तो ऐसा नहीं है ना कि आज उसने किया और कल ही उसको जेल भेज दिया जाएगा। देयर विल बी अ प्रोसेस, देयर विल बी अ कंप्लेंट रिटन, देयर विल बी देयर विल जब भेजा जाएगा तो उससे पहले निर्धारित किया जाएगा कि उसके एग्जिस्टिंग एसेट से कितना मुआवजा दिया जा सकता है। मुख्तार अब्बास नकवी हैज रिएक्टेड सर, जस्ट गोइंग अक्रॉस टू दैट।
तो क्या वो सारे के सारे संवैधानिक कामों के लिए बने हुए हैं? सारी गई, अगर आप डाइवोर्स पे कानून बना हुआ है, अगर वो मर्डर पे कानून बने हुए हैं, अगर चोरी पे कानून बना हुआ है, अगर नक्सलवाद और आतंकवाद पे कानून बना हुआ है, तो क्या ये सारी चीजें जो हैं वो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल है क्या? अनकॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल है इनलीगल है, इसीलिए कानून बनाया जाता है। और कानून जो बना है वो मैं मानता हूं कि ये जरूरी था, ये बहुत पहले बनना चाहिए था, जब 1984-85 में इस पर चर्चा हुई थी शाबानो केस में, उस समय भी कांग्रेस का जो व्यवहार था लगभग उसी को लगता है कांग्रेस पार्टी दोहरा रही है। और कांग्रेस के लिए, कांग्रेस को ये बूमरैंग करेगा और कांग्रेस के लिए ये इस तरह का व्यवहार वाटरलू साबित होगा।
ओवैसी साहब ने प्रधानमंत्री पर निजी टिप्पणी
की, मुझे लगता है ये जितने भी इस तरह की निजी टिप्पणियां, ये
Welcome back. I'm just going to quickly go across to Sharon, who's also been tracking the developments around the Teen Talaq bill, which bans or criminalizes instant triple talaq and also announces stringent punishment while taking care and trying to safeguard the interest of the woman who's been subjected to that atrocity, trying to bring in gender justice in society. One of the bills that across society, across the spectrum, people should actually welcome, but there are those, the patriarchs, who've been standing up against it. Sharon, who all have you spoken to and what's been the reaction?
Well, Anand, even before the landmark judgment by the Apex Court, Times Now has been talking to all these petitioners and also the victims of triple talaq, and they all have been said the trauma, the situation that they go through is immense, and they want justice. They want justice from the government, and they have been saying this ever since the whole issue had come up. Now, even after that, Supreme Court gave the landmark judgment, but even after that, we have been seeing cases, and around 67 cases that which has come up where man has been giving triple talaq to their wife. So clearly this is something that the women activists that I have been speaking to, they all have been saying this is the time when they want the opposition, all the parties to come together and come on a consensus, right, in regard to triple talaq. They want justice
for themselves. Sharon, just pulling away from you, lot of reactions coming through, various political voices. Manoj Jha is speaking.
चाहते हैं भारतीय जनता पार्टी हर नारी को, नारी सशक्तिकरण, नारी का हक मिले, किसी नारी को इस तरह से उसके जीवन को बर्बाद न किया जाए। अगर ये लोग किसी तलाकशुदा ऐसी औरत से मिले होते, उसका दर्द समझे होते, तब शायद कुछ बोल पाते। मैं समझता हूँ ये बहुत ही ऐतिहासिक दिन है जब तीन तलाक को कानूनी जवाब बनाने का संसद ने, भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने शुरुआत कर दी है।
I think those who are opposing carry a very regressive mindset. We must be progressive. This law is very progressive for the nation.
अच्छा बिल है ना महिलाओं का अधिकार के लिए,
लेकिन जितना इसका विरोध किया जा रहा है कि इससे अपराध बढ़ेंगे,
जो विरोध कर रहे हैं वो लोग राजनीति खेल कर रहे हैं।
लेकिन जो यूपीए सरकार में सवालों का केस था उसके भी कांग्रेस पर,
वो तो सबको मालूम है कांग्रेस का कहानी।
हमारे साथ
Well, plenty of reactions coming through. We also have Mr. Syed Inayatullah joining us at this point. But before we go across to our guests, I just want to play out that entire sequence, if we can, short excerpts of when the triple talaq bill was tabled in the Lok Sabha, what Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad, the Union Law Minister, said, how Asaduddin Owaisi stood up to oppose it, and then the counter that came from the Law Minister.
I beg to move for leave to introduce a bill to protect the rights of married Muslim women and to prohibit divorce by pronouncing triple talaq by their husbands and to provide for matters connected therewith or incidental thereto.
Consultation did not happen. Madam, this bill, if it is passed, will be an injustice to Muslim women, okay, will lead to abandonment of Muslim women. What the bill is required
is to make a law wherein 20 lakh women who are abandoned by married people who do not belong to Muslim community, which also includes our bhabhi in Gujarat, should be given justice, madam. It is not being done by this.
आज हम इतिहास बना रहे हैं. ये जो आपत्तियां आई हैं, मैं एक बात कहना चाहूंगा, ये पूरा कानून न किसी पूजा का है, न प्रार्थना का है, न इबादत का है, न मजहब का है. ये कानून है नारी न्याय, नारी गरिमा और नारी सम्मान का. तलाके बिद्दत को गैर कानूनी कहा, अगर उसके बाद भी तीन तलाक चलता है, लोग महिलाएं सड़कों पे फेंक दी जाती हैं, उनके गुजारे का कोई इंजाम नहीं होता है, तो क्या ये सदन खामोश रहेगी? सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने कहा ये पाप है, पाप के बावजूद अगर ये पाप किया जाएगा तो क्या ये सदन खामोश रहेगी? तीसरी बात, ये लोग राइट टू इक्वालिटी की बात कर रहे हैं, ये फंडामेंटल राइट की बात कर रहे हैं. माननीय अध्यक्ष महोदया, आज इस सदन को यह तय करना है कि तीन तलाक की पीड़ित महिलाओं का, बेटियों का, बहनों.
तो सीधी सी बात है कि जो ट्रिपल तलाक के समर्थक हैं, इसका मतलब वो चाहते हैं कि 8 करोड़ महिलाओं पर अत्याचार होते रहना चाहिए. एक किस्म से इसके साथ साथ वो कुरान शरीफ, रसूल, इसका भी अपमान कर रहे हैं और खुदा के प्रति भी गुनाह कर रहे हैं. मुझे ये लगता है कि जो लोग 8 करोड़ महिलाओं को सम्मान देने के विरोध में हैं, उनके खिलाफ कानूनी कार्रवाई का भी प्रावधान बनना चाहिए. ना खुदा उनको माफ करेगा, ना इस्लाम उनको माफ करेगा. और इसलिए 8 करोड़ से अधिक मुस्लिम महिलाओं को.
यू हर्ड व्हाट इंद्रेश कुमार सेड देयर, मिस्टर सैयद इनायतुल्ला, व्हाई इज देयर दिस ऑपोजिशन when there is 50% of the Muslim community gets an option to for legal recourse against injustice meted out to them?
First of all, there is no need to have any legislation on the triple talaq, because our Quran itself is very clear about this triple talaq. Why you people, these politicians, particularly the Sangh Parivar, they wanted to take up their issue and make the Muslims unpopular among the other.
Not at all, sir.
See, have you this got one? Any statistical data? No, have you got any statistical data?
Right,
that how
the
many
Shabanu
Muslim
case
women
in 1985,
been suffering
there
due
case
to the
after case
talaq,
in the Honorable Supreme
how
Court,
many
sir?
Women in Hindu
this
community
not, this
are
not,
suffering from the talaq
there is,
and
there is,
separation.
There is,
so many
there
you
is
not
there
taken
is,
anything. One
there
thing,
is,
you are,
there
you
is, dowry, there is a law against dowry. There is a law against forced eviction. There is legal recourse that is available for women across other communities. But I am asking you, sir, what does the Quran say about talaq-e-biddat? And
see,
what is the punishment that is given to the man?
To
you tell
woman.
Me, Mr. Inayatullah, as far as
no,
part
no, no,
of the Milli
no,
Council,
no,
you tell
no,
me,
no,
sir,
no,
when a man gives triple talaq to a woman, what is the legal recourse for her? What is the option for her? What is the option for her?
See, triple talaq is not in at a time. They don't know.
Sir,
they
I said talaq-e-biddat.
Innocent people.
I said instant
who are
triple talaq.
Expressing the triple talaq at a time.
Sir, those people.
No,
why is it being validated?
So you are making. You
why
are
is it
confusing the people?
Not at all, Mr. Inayatullah. I am very clear about what is talaq-e-biddat. I know
no
what is
triple
talaq. There is, sir. There is, and that has been given via WhatsApp.
No,
when they say talaq, 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 they send a WhatsApp, and then they say I have given. They send it by post. They put it on Facebook or they send it by text, and that's being validated by Maulanas and clerics across this country. Why is that being done? The entire
no,
issue
Rahul,
had your community
is a completely misunderstood.
No,
it's
sir.
A misconceived.
It's not
there
misunderstood.
Is no
misconceived.
At a time. Talaq can be given only in one menses period.
No, sir.
After one menses period
what,
and another menses period,
that is what
he
you're
has
talking about.
Express
that
triple
that
talaq.
Is what you're
talaq.
Talking about. Talaq-e-ahsan. You're talking about when the wife exercises the option of khula. But I am talking about talaq-e-biddat, where in Sharia or in the past, as it is chronicled, there was a displeasure at somebody who gave talaq-e-biddat or triple talaq in one go, and that person was supposed to be punished. Thus, kode ka parman tha uske upar, and that each one, each koda should actually exact flesh out of that person.
You please tell me if that is wrong. Can you give, is there not an equivalent of that? Is it there in our constitution today? We cannot give that kind of a punishment to a man today.
See,
because we are following the constitution of this
Mr.
country.
Rahul,
this is Anand here, Mr. Saeed Inayatullah. This is Anand Narasimhan
here. There is no such triple talak at a time in the Quran itself.
Sir, you will not, sir, it is being given, there are people who are trying to defend it, they are saying that it is wrong, but it is still mandated. There are people who have said within the community today, Mr. Inayatullah, you are saying it doesn't exist. Sujay Kantawala wants to intervene. Yes, Sujay.
Our Quran is
the law
very
minister
clear.
Himself gave an instance that while he was addressing the house, he himself gave an instance.
Yes.
And look at it this way. Why are only these men, not a single woman has opposed this? Only the men, the patriarchal medieval mindset, they are opposing this. In fact, this places Muslim women on a higher pedestal than Hindu women. It is such a well-balanced piece of legislation. It also opens the room for reconciliation. Where does the traumatized Muslim woman go? Where does my Muslim sister go for justice? This is why we need to welcome and we need to protect her fundamental rights, Anand.
एक ऑप्शन मिला है आज मुस्लिम महिलाओं को कि अगर उनके साथ तलाक बिद्दत होती है या इंस्टेंट तीन तलाक उनको दिया जाता है तो उनके पास एक ऑप्शन है कि इसको कंप्लेन करें, इस पर लीगल रिकोर्स ले और जिसने भी उनके साथ ये किया है उसको सजा दिलवाएं. आप क्या कहना चाहेंगे इस बिल पर?
देखिए, मैं तो चाहती हूँ कि जो कुरान साहब कुरान के अल्लाह के कानून के सूरह तलाक के पावर के अगेंस्ट कोई तलाक के पावर का मिसयूज कर रहा है तो उसकी मजिस्ट्रेट पूरी तरह से काउंसलिंग करे और अगर उसको दोषी पाया जा रहा है और वो औरत भी उसको सजा देने के लिए पक्ष में है तो जरूर सजा हो, लेकिन उस औरत की मेंटेनेंस और उसको उसका उसकी पूरी तरह से सुरक्षा और रोटी की व्यवस्था होनी चाहिए. क्योंकि जो शौहर को अगर जेल हो गई वो तो जेल में रोटी खाएगा
जी.
लेकिन वो औरत जो घर से निकाल दी गई, उसके ससुराल वालों ने कहा भाग जाओ, तुमने मेरे बेटे को जेल भिजवा दिया है, मैं तुमको रोटी दूंगी, तो वो तो चली गई घर से बाहर. लेकिन मजिस्ट्रेट की फिर यहाँ पर ड्यूटी बन जाती है कि जो 1987 का मेंटेनेंस एक्ट है, जो वक्फ डिपार्टमेंट देता है, वक्फ मंत्रालय देता है, वो बिहार में भी चल रहा है. तो जैसे ही उसके जेल में अगर उसके जेल जाता है तो वो रोटी तो वहाँ खा रहा है, लेकिन इसको घर का सहारा नहीं, इसको रोटी का सहारा नहीं, इसके बच्चों का सहारा नहीं. इसलिए मेंटेनेंस एक्ट उसके तुरंत मजिस्ट्रेट उसको तुरंत उसकी व्यवस्था करके उसके मेंटेनेंस लगाए.
इस बिल जिसको कि आज टेबल किया गया है, शाइस्ता जी, हमने इसको पढ़ा है, इसकी कॉपी को पढ़ा है, जहाँ पर बिल्कुल इस पर तवज्जो दी गई है कि मेंटेनेंस का इजहार हो और जो जो कॉम्पनसेशन जो होना चाहिए वाइफ को और द कस्टडी जो है माइनर चाइल्ड की उसको मिलनी चाहिए, इस पर भी एहतियात किया गया है. आप नहीं जानती है कि सदन जो है इसको पारित करे, इसको पास करे?
बिल्कुल पास करे, बिल्कुल. क्योंकि और लेकिन मेंटेनेंस में ये पॉइंट जरूर आना चाहिए
जी
कि जैसे ही उसको जेल के लिए ऑर्डर आता है वैसे ही इसकी मेंटेनेंस के भी ऑर्डर होनी चाहिए. क्योंकि फिर वो उसको रोटी कहाँ मिलेगी, बच्चों की छत कहाँ मिलेगी, बच्चों को घर क्योंकि ससुराल में तो इज्जत भी नहीं गुजार पाएगी.
ये सही कंसर्न है और इसको सदन में बिल्कुल उठाया जाएगा और हम भी जब बीजेपी के लोगों से बात करेंगे, सरकार से बात करेंगे तो इस बात पर इस बात की पुष्टि उनसे मांगेंगे. शाइस्ता अंबर जी, थैंक यू फॉर स्पीकिंग टू अस. हैव टू टेक अ वेरी वेरी शॉर्ट ब्रेक. रिक्वेस्ट आवर गेस्ट टू स्टे ऑन. वेलकम बैक. द तीन तलाक बिल फाइंड्स ब्लॉकेड, विल इट गेट पैसेज इन द लोकसभा, बट विल इट गेट विल इट स्टंबल इन द राज्यसभा एज पोलिटिकल पार्टीज टेंड टू बैक पेट्रियार्की और जस्ट फॉर द सेक ऑफ अपोजिंग समथिंग दैट दिस गवर्नमेंट इज प्रपोजिंग आर लुकिंग टू पंच होल्स. वेदर दे स्टैंड अप यूनाइटेड फॉर द वुमेन ऑफ दिस कंट्री एंड फॉर जेंडर जस्टिस रिमेन्स टू बी सीन. प्लेंटी ऑफ रिएक्शन कमिंग थ्रू, लेट्स लिसन इन.
देखिए, पहली बात ये कि आज संसद के इतिहास का एक बहुत ही ऐतिहासिक दिन है और ऐतिहासिक दिन इसलिए मैं कह रहा हूं कि जो काम बहुत पहले हो जाना चाहिए था, लगभग 7 दशकों से देश की मुस्लिम महिलाएं अपने संवैधानिक अधिकारों के लिए संघर्ष कर रही थी, और कहीं ना कहीं किन्हीं न किन्हीं कारणों से जो पार्टी सबसे ज्यादा समय तक सत्ता में रही कांग्रेस पार्टी, वो एक कदम आगे और दो कदम पीछे चलती रही, और जिसका ये नतीजा हुआ कि आज मुस्लिम महिलाओं के संवैधानिक अधिकार खत्म हो गए हैं।
तलाक में जब जासमिन जेल में रहेगा तो फिर क्या कौन पैदा?
देखिए, जो आपको इस बिल में जो आपको खामियां लगती हैं, तो ये पार्लियामेंट का फोरम ही इसलिए है कि आप वहाँ पे डिबेट करिए और डिस्कस करिए और अपना विरोध जताइए। लेकिन जिस बिल से औरतों का सम्मान बढ़ता है, उनको इक्वालिटी मिलती है, उनको सुरक्षा मिलती है, आप उस बिल का ही विरोध करिए, तो मैं समझती हूँ इस पार्लियामेंट में जो खड़े होकर इसका विरोध कर रहा है वो एंटी वुमेन है और महिला विरोधी है।
ट्रिपल तलाक बिल पर लोकसभा,
आई वेलकम दिस बिल, द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया मैंडेट्स इक्वालिटी फॉर मेन एंड वुमेन।
That is Harsimrat Kaur Badal coming out and saying, why would you want to oppose something which empowers women? And that's a straightforward question, and that's the plank that's being used. Athar Khan, also with us, our consulting editor, you've spoken to a lot of people and you've been tracking the developments around this. It was expected that there will be a certain brand of politics that will be played. But is it needless, Athar, on a matter like this?
Well, you are absolutely right, Anand, when you say it was expected. Some amount of politics was expected, especially from groups like the MIM and other Muslim groups as well. The Congress Party, of course, is walking a tight line right now. They have come out in principle in support of the anti-instant oral triple talaq in one sitting bill, with some riders suggesting that the onus of proving that the triple talaq has been given should not be on the woman, should be on the man itself. Also, people like Owaisi came out, and we all saw the speech. He did raise some points which perhaps might have some constitutional value, or perhaps purely strictly in a legal sense, but the larger principle here is one of gender justice. The Supreme Court is very clear on this. Instant triple talaq, oral triple talaq in one sitting is null and void. It is illegal in this country, and any man who does try and give oral instant triple talaq in one sitting is violating the law of the land. Now, why has the government come out with a reinforcement, really? And that's what you can call this bill. This is a reinforcement of what the Supreme Court has already laid down. It had to be done, given the fact we saw some cases coming out even after the Supreme Court banned the oral triple talaq in this country. There were close to 60 cases, Anand, that were reported, at least not just in the media, yes, but also to the law enforcement agencies. So the reinforcement bit is very important. The politics will play out, of course. There will be some adjustments, perhaps, given the fact that the government does want to clear this. They have a lot of political capital. This particular dispensation has a lot of political capital riding on this, Anand. Let's make no mistake about that. And they will push through this, and they will want to push through this with all they have at their disposal. We can expect people like Owaisi and other Muslim groups to come out and suggest this is being down to hound and harass people, but clearly not many takers for that as of now, Anand.
Yes, and the BJP is now drawing parallels between Rahul Gandhi and Rajiv Gandhi. After GVL Narasimha Rao, you have got RP Singh also coming out and saying, from Shah Banu to Shaira Banu, Rajiv Gandhi to Rahul Gandhi, neither Muslim clerics have changed, nor has INC India, that's where he stacked the Congress party and the AIMIM party. Vote bank politics of appeasement and male dominance in the garb of religion is what he has said. Let's listen in to Dr. Subramanian Swamy and Rajiv Shukla.
He said he will oppose the triple talaq.
Let him oppose, he has no votes in the parliament. Let him go to court or let him move amendments.
And the kind of objections that have been raised by other parties also, Congress has also said that the maintenance issue must be taken care of.
All right, move amendments. That is why parliament is there. What is the use of crying about it? Move amendments and see if you can pass them. If you don't pass them, go to court.
Well, plenty of responses, reactions that have come through. We're way over time here on this edition of Newsroom 365. Do stay on with us. We continue to stay with the day's biggest development and also keep close tabs on what's happening in Parliament. Do stay with us.